Okay, hi everyone. This is a short video that I wanted to make about a repair that I've just completed to this absolutely incredible Yamaha MX-1 power amplifier. Now, it's a bit hard to see what it looks like, but here's the front panel. This sort of helps. It looks like that, and it is just a monster. This thing is a monster. It weighs maybe 25 kilos, two huge power transformers, four big filter caps, and they're big. Each of those, I think, is 30,000 microfarad. This is a really cool amp. That's a whole amplifier block there. You'll note that each channel, you can't really see that, but each channel has dual diode bridges. Might be easier to see on this side. There's the other channel. Oh, it is a bit hard to see that, but anyway, there are two diode bridges attached to a heatsink. So each channel has two heatsink diode bridges. Just extraordinary. This thing is beautifully put together. It's very dirty and dusty, but I've given it a really good clean. Now, the problem is that it wouldn't power on. Very, very strange. Just would not power on. Well, I say it wouldn't power on. You could turn it on, and this little front panel LED would light, but that's all that would happen. There was primary voltage, obviously, from the mains. The fuse was good. There are two onboard fuses here. These are in the secondary side. They're on the secondary side. So they were all good. And the primary fuse was good. So nothing had blown. And I'm testing this and I'm thinking, what is going on? There's voltage here on the inlet side, and yet I'm not seeing any secondary voltages here. I just couldn't figure it out for about, well, for a good hour or so, I couldn't figure it out. But anyway, then after looking at the schematic, here's what we have. We have a little soft start circuit, and this is what I could, you know, it made sense. This is not a big clunking actual power switch. It's just a sort of a big switch that has a very soft puny action, and that's because all it's doing is it's operating the amplifier via this little soft start separate power supply. So we've got a little transformer here. There's a transistor that's doing some switching. There's a relay here as well. Now, what's interesting is that the relay, there were loads of dry joints on this board. This transistor was almost hanging out. None of its leads were soldered. Well, they originally were, but they were all completely cracked. The whole thing was just loose. This had one lead that had literally vaporized. This relay, one of its leads had literally kind of vaporized all of the area around the lead so that it was no longer attached to the printed circuit board. So in other words, the amp couldn't turn on because this could not turn it on. This couldn't switch it. This is not able to switch it because the mechanism by which that switching would occur was disabled because the components were no longer soldered to the board. So long story short, we fixed this soft start board. And now what I'm doing, we've got it all powered up. On the variac, you'll know if you watch my videos that this is what we like to do. It's the safest way to go. So we've got exactly 240 volts here. Well, is it? Let's have a quick check. Let's have a look. Well, close, 241. That's lower than we normally get. So 241. Power consumption, 75 watts, which sounds, you know, that's about right for a big powerful amp like this. That's a Class AB amplifier. And we're looking for around 14 millivolts across the emitter resistors of each channel for our bias adjustment. And the bias adjustment is made just in there. So this is a real, I'm extremely pleased. The reason why I'm pleased is this guy, the owner, absolutely loves this thing. And I can see why. I mean, why wouldn't you love it? What's not to love? What an absolute monster. He thought it was dead for good. And it's not. It's revived. The beast lives. So very, very happy with that. I'll put this up on my YouTube channel very soon, and you'll see it on the Liquid Audio website. Don't forget, for all your vintage hi-fi needs, Liquid Audio in Perth. Reach me via my website. Thanks for watching.